Lasers, MIG welding, wire-fed processes. Let's sling some wire. Welcome back to the channel, everyone. And if you've been keeping up, we've been doing some experiments when it comes to these laser welders and other welding machines and processes, and just comparing and seeing what we see that's going on different. Today, we've got a pretty simple experiment. We've got our T-joints fit up with quarter inch plate, and we've got our laser welder and our MIG welding process already set up, and we're gonna do the classic fillet weld brake test. Let's get into it. Today's MIG welder we're gonna be using is the Lincoln Electric 260 PowerMIG. It's a pretty sweet machine, and we're going to be using the presets for both of these machines, the welder and the laser. We're going to go ahead and select MIG welding. We're going to be doing steel on our carbon steel. We're going to be using 035 Super Arc Lincoln Electric MIG wire as well. It's basically your 7ES6, and we're going to have that 7525 gas and roll that up for quarter inch plate with our positive polarity at 21 volts and 370 on the wire feed. Now we can put on our trusty yellow hood. We already got our weld joints tacked up. We can just run a bead. Just run that first beat. And we've got our MIG weld right here. We made sure we had a bit of a push angle. We got the right parameters for the quarter inch steel, the presets that come with the machine. Now let's go to the laser. The LightWELD XC is on and powered up. Again, we always just go off this little preset guide of as far as what we're gonna end up welding. We've already got it set to E8 as far as the modes, and we're turned all, the beans are all the way up at 1500 watts for this quarter inch stuff. We're running 100% argon compared to 7525. I don't know if that's gonna change anything with the strength. Maybe you guys in the comments will let us know if really that is gonna affect the strength of the weld. My anticipation, the laser is gonna have more penetration and will be harder to break on that fillet weld test. The wire feeder is set to 40. We've got the same Super Arc MIG wire that's off in this wire feeder. So we've got the same filler metal. All we gotta do now is laser weld, but we can't use this freaking hood. That's not made for laser welding. We've got our Kentech laser safe welding hood right here. And I've already been wearing my laser safe safety glasses. So I've got those on. And again, we're locked in our laser safe barrier because we've got people outside the shop that we don't want to damage their retinas with this infrared light. So let's go ahead and snip it, clip it, and just whip it and put a bead on this quarter inch plate. I've never actually laser welded anything this thick so far. So this will be the thickest thing I've welded. So I'm really curious to see even what it looks like. Can't tell if I'm going too slow or not. I just want to make sure it gets enough penetration because it's way smaller of a weld.
And so there's our laser weld here, and it's just, you can see the heat input is way less. Obviously the weld size is way less, but I am curious or not whether that got the depth of penetration that that MIG weld got. Here are both the welds side by side. You can see the difference in size. Definitely have a convex and a concave fillet weld size, you know, so if maybe the code was calling for something like that, it might be something to really consider, you know, something along that nature. But let's get that hammer right there and beat them over sideways. I don't know if a clamp is going to be probably going to be in my way. I'll just go ahead and laser weld to the back of this table here. Why not? This thing is so cool to play with, though. All right, that ought to not go anywhere. If I strike these fillet welds this way, it should be easy to break this weld, but that weld won't be able to get pulled back that way. So let's mollywop some steel. I'll be honest, after making both of those welds, I'm not sure if this laser weld is as strong as I thought it was going to be. That MIG weld's on there. And, you know, I guess only we'll find out right now. I better move stuff before I start breaking stuff. We just got that out of the way because y'all are about to see all 170 pounds of me
get freaking nuts.
Lock some wheels down. Lock this wheel. That would make welds pretty strong. Pretty strong so far. Whew. Maybe the editor can edit that in at how many swings it took. See if I can't do the same amount of swings here or more, less. Let's see. Oh man, that snapped right the heck off. Whew, interesting. So as simple as those welds were, it is still interesting as far as the data we recovered with just simple hammer strikes. Now the MIG weld took considerable amounts of more hammer strikes in order to break it. We obviously bent even some of the steel, but I think that has a lot to do with the reinforcement that the weld had involved with it. There's some kind of weird stuff in the root of our MIG weld here too. I'm not really sure what that was. I thought something was kind of looking weird. It looks like some porosity. I'm not sure what kind of trash we pulled up from God knows where. The MIG weld did really well, but I do think it's just kind of sitting on that plate. It's not as deep of penetrating as I do see in this laser weld. Now I say that, I just see that this seems to be a little bit more cutting into the actual plate itself with the laser weld. Now the grains look completely different. Like that looks completely different than that weld. You see it's a lot less coarse of a grain structure than this right here, which is kind of fascinating. If you guys have a good explanation on why that might be, we'd love to hear it inside the comments. But I do think the laser did penetrate more into the metal, but just for the sheer amount of lack of reinforcement, it was easier to burn. So I'm not saying one necessarily did better than the other, but I mean, the proof is in the pudding. The MIG weld did take a lot more hammer strikes to break. We could probably change some things with the actual laser welder itself, maybe try to feed some more wire, turn up the actual wattage, because we're using the LightWELD XC and it's actually only rated for 5/32 as far as thickness. Quarter inch is a little heavy duty for it. But hey, that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to experiment and try new things with lasers, with MIG welding, and we're trying to teach you guys everything that we can learn at the same time. So check us out inside the Weld app on our other social media platforms and here on YouTube. Until then, we'll see you on the next one.